In DOS and early Windows versions, the so-called 8.3 filename was being used. This means that filenames could only have up to 8 characters for the filename itself and 3 additional characters for the file extension. Later Windows versions then allowed longer filenames while still allowing backwards compatibility. People had an argument in the comment section of one of my earlier videos about when the ability to give files longer names was introduced and how it was realized. Let's figure it out. Here in Windows 3.11, we have just created a test folder in our C drive in order to create a test file within it. Now that we are in Notepad, we have created a test file, just a text file with a little text, and we want to save it into our test folder on our C drive. Let's see if Windows 3.11 will accept a very long filename. Seemingly, it does not. And with all the trying, I had to conclude that I needed to comply with the 8.3 filename and give this file a short name with 8 characters or less. Okay. Let's see if DOS is also able to read from the file and to see the file. Let's try to view our file in DOS. We see what's in our C drive. There's a test directory and we cd into our test directory. Let's see what's in there. There's a file named short.txt. That's the file that we have just created with the same name, and we can open this file or access the contents of the file by just using type short.txt. Okay, let's do the same thing in Windows 95 and see how Windows 95 deals with it. First of all, we don't need to open the file explorer anymore in order to create a directory, because Windows 95 already supports creating directories right from the save dialog. So again, we open Notepad and type in a text to create a simple text file. Now that we are on the save dialog, we can create a directory right from the save dialog, and already we can give the test folder a longer name. We don't just name it test, we name it test folder. And we also give our test file a long name. See if Windows 95 accepts it. Well, it does. And at this point, I'm pretty interested in how this file now looks like in the file explorer and how this file looks like seeing its properties. So in the file explorer, we get a long name displayed. And if we go to the properties, we can see that this file has a long name, but also it has a second name, which is the MS-DOS name. That's a shorter name for the file. So this file actually seems to have two names, and I think it will become more clear what happened right here if we go to the MS-DOS mode. If you remember, Windows 95 still had the ability to boot into MS-DOS. I had to cut the video right here for resolution purposes, screen resolution purposes. Let's go into our Z drive, and we see already that our test folder doesn't have the name test folder. It rather has the name test fo number one. Let's go to test fo number one, and we see that our test file also has a shorter name than the name we gave it. This is now the MS-DOS name of the file, but from MS-DOS we are able to access the contents of the file. So this is the backwards compatibility. DOS doesn't come with a long name, but it is able to read from the file with a long name. What happened right here? Well, the 8.3 file name was indeed being used by DOS and early Windows versions. Similar file naming schemes have also existed on different earlier operating systems like CPM and Atari. The file naming convention is limited by the FAT file system. As a new variant of FAT, the file allocation table, WeFAT then allowed long file names in addition to the classic 8.3 names. WeFAT was introduced with Windows 95 and Windows NT 3.5. To maintain backwards compatibility with legacy applications on DOS and Windows 3.11, on FAT and WeFAT systems, an 8.3 file name is automatically generated for every long file name. So let's imagine we have the year 1996. You just bought a new computer with Windows 95 and you created some documents, ideally with long file names, that you are willing to give your neighbor who still uses Windows 3.11 or even older than that. In this case, you can just write your documents to a floppy disk and bring them over to your neighbor. She or he might not be able to see the entire file names, but will indeed be able to continue working on the documents and then bring the floppy disk back to you. Even modern operating systems use an alternate file name to the long file name for compatibility with legacy programs. After all that being said, here's a side note. If you had Windows 3.11 and you daily wanted to give files longer names, it could have been possible to realize this by additional software. Therefore, if someone claims to have used longer file names in Windows versions prior to 95, he or she might not necessarily be lying. Thank you for watching and God bless you. Bye.